why my days had to be so stressful.
Did you know that stress spelled backwards is desserts?
Well, thanks, Esther, for that wonderful piece of information.
Speaking of desserts, Esther, have you guys ever tasted copper mud?
Okay. What exactly is copper mud?
Only the best ice cream in the world.
Okay, guys, give me just a second. I need to take this.
Hello.
Speaking of ice cream, did you know that it's actually a Chinese food?
Okay.
Chinese food?
Yeah.
Yes, Esther, because they had freezers in China.
Totally.
I like Asians more now.
All right, we'll be right there. Okay, guys, we got a case.
Guys, where have you been? What, did you get lost?
Actually, yeah, we did.
We didn't know the campground would be so hard to find.
So what have we got?
Small boy, maybe around the age of 6. Can't tell how long he's been deceased, though, because he's in an airtight barrel.
That's strange.
Geez, what's even stranger is what the body's buried with. I mean, look.
It's a teddy bear and a blanket.
It's almost like the suspect was trying to comfort the victim.
Look at the body. It's posed as if the child were sleeping.
That's a little freaky.
Check out the symbol on that tree. It matches the one on the barrel.
Yeah, that's really weird, because I saw a ton of them on the way up here that's similar to that.
Wait, does that mean there's more bodies?
Looks like it.
Yeah. All right, we interviewed Sarah Taylor, John Picklesheimer, Joe Whitaker, and Lisa Chase. Who's next on the list?
We've got Miss Mesher. She's the music teacher or something like that. She's right here.
All right, let's pay her a visit. Hi, we're from CBFD. I'm Chief West, and this is Dr. Shea. We'd like to ask you a few questions, if you wouldn't mind.
Okay.
We need to ask you some questions regarding the disappearances about, you know, the bodies found over at Hartbrock Campground. We understand that you knew some of the victims, and we were wondering if you could help us out by answering a few questions.
Okay.
Okay, so exactly how well did you know these boys right here?
I have a strong connection with all my students. I love them, and I think of them as my own. Okay. Michael, take that hat off.
Okay, did you notice anything suspicious, maybe around that happened to the children, any people that were talking to them, just any suspicious behavior at all?
No. Well, there was this one boy about 4 years ago. His name was Brandon. His name was Brandon. And he was talking about the janitor and how he said he was going to, or the janitor was going to come by his house sometime. But as far as I know, he's out in California. Michael, clean that up.
Yes, Mother.
So, do you have any other children besides Michael?
Michael's not, I only have one son.
So, that boy that you mentioned, would he happen to be any of those right there?
That one does.
Okay, thank you. That will be all that we've got right now, but if we have any more questions, we'll come back and ask you again later. Is that okay?
It was nice to meet you all.
All right, let's pull all the evidence together. What have you guys got?
Well, all of the bodies were buried with children's blankets and a teddy bear, and plus they were all positioned as if they were sleeping. That kind of leads me to believe that the suspect was very nurturing towards the kids.
Okay, also we need to keep in mind that all of the victims have very similar characteristics. They all have the same age, they're all the same age, they have the same hair color and features as well.
Maybe the suspect wants kids, but she doesn't think that she can handle anyone above that age range.
It could be that the suspect lost a child and trying to keep the memory by kidnapping other kids.
That would explain why all the kids are the same age and they look alike.
In the toxicology report here, it showed that all the victims were poisoned with arsenic. Poisoning is something usually indicative to women. Women kill with poison.
Arsenic is also very quick and painless, which leads me to believe that the suspect didn't want any of the victims to suffer.
And also, the bodies were all found in airtight barrels, which means that she probably wanted to preserve the bodies, almost like she didn't want to die.
Let's call McCoy and see what she found with the symbols.
Alright, go McCoy.
Okay, yeah, so you'll never believe what I've got. Each of the symbols had one single capital letter in it. When you put them together, the letters spell out three possible names. Only one of the names showed up in the database, though. That name was Noah Mesher.
Didn't we talk to an Elizabeth Mesher? She was like the music teacher that traveled around all the schools.
Exactly. Already ahead of you. Elizabeth Mesher is Noah's mother. And in the database, it also says that Noah was killed in the awful car crash. And in the police report, it also says that the accident was Elizabeth's fault. She randomly ran off the road and T-boned a tree. Killed Noah instantly. And FYI, Noah's obituary picture looks just like all the other victims.
A traumatic event like that could have driven her to commit all these crimes.
Her most recent address is already in your inbox.
Thanks, McCoy.
Alright, let's go.
Open up. Elizabeth, we have a warrant.
I don't think anyone's home.
I think Alexis is right.
Lock, key, you guys go around back. Lee, open the door and come with me. Nobody's home. All right, let's spread out and see what we can find.
Okay.
Hey, Alexis.
Yeah?
I just found some barrels downstairs.
You're kidding. Look at this picture and tell me if this does not look just like the boy we found.
Oh my gosh, it looks just like him.
Hey, guys.
Yeah?
Look what I found upstairs. There's a whole closet full of them.
Wow. Oh my God. I think that's everything we just needed.
Arsenic. I think we've got enough evidence to put somebody away for a long time. Question is, where's Elizabeth?
Well, we need to find her before she kills another innocent kid.
Definitely.
This new town has given me the opportunity to always keep you here in my memory, every day. You, my son, will always remain in my heart, always.
May you eternally rest